Oh, 'tis of a bold major tale I'll relate, who possessed a fine house and a charming estate, who, when possible, always his pleasure would take from morning till night in a boat on his lake. So a steam launch he bought from a neighboring pier and learned how to start her, to stoke and to steer. But part of the craft he omitted to learn, how to ease her and to stop her and back her astern. Well, one lovely spring morn from their moorings they cast, the furnace alight and the steam in full blast. As they cruised through the lake, oh, what pleasure was theirs, what congratulations, what swagger, what airs. Evening's come, says the major, let's home for the night. I'll pick up the mooring and make her all right, whilst you make my gay stoker your wages to earn. Just ease her and stop her and back her astern. Do what? Asked the stoker. Why, stop her, of course. Faith, it's easier stopping a runaway horse. Just try it yourself, the field officer swore. But that was no use, they were nearly on shore. He swore at himself, at the boat and the crew. He cursed at the funnel, the boiler and screw. But in vain he was forced from his mooring to turn, shouting, ease her, stop her, and back her astern. It was clear that on shore they that night would not dine, so they drank up the brandy, the whiskey, and wine. They finished the stew and demolished the cake, and they steamed at full speed all the night round the lake. Weeks passed, and with terror and famine oppressed, one by one of that ill-fated crew sank to rest. And grim death seized the major before he could learn how to ease her and stop her and back her astern. And still round the lake their wild course they pursue, while the ghost of the major still swears at the crew, and the ghosts of the crew still reply in this mode, just ease her and stop her yourself and be blowed. Here's the moral, Imprimus, whene'er you're afloat, don't use haughty words to your crew on your boat. And ere starting, oh, make this your deepest concern, learn to ease her and stop her and back her astern. Come, all you young gallants that follow the gun, beware of late shooting at the setting sun, for it's little you know of what happened of late to young Meliastrine, whose beauty was great. It happened one evening in a shower of hail, this maid in a bower did herself conceal. Her love be a shooting took her for a fawn. He leveled his gun and he shot Molly Bawn. And when he came to her and found it was she, his limbs, they grew feeble, and his eyes could not see. His heart, it was broken with sorrow and grief, and with eyes up to heaven, he implored for relief. He ran to his uncle with a gun in his hand, saying, uncle, dear uncle, I'm not able to stand. I shot my own true lover, alas, I'm undone, while she was in the shade by the setting of the sun. I rubbed her fair temples and found she was dead, and a fountain of tears for my darling I shed. And now I'll be forced by the laws of the land for the killing of my darling, my trial to stand.
Thank you.
There was an old man down by Killyburn Brae, had a scolding old wife for the most of his day. One day as this man he walked out in the glen, sure he met with the devil, says, "How are you then?" Says he, "Me old man, I have come for your wife, for I hear she's the plague and torment of your life." So the devil he hoisted her up on his back, and hot foot for hell with her then did he pack. And when at the finish they got to hell's gate, sure he threw her right down with a thump on her pate. There were two little devils there playing at ball, whilst the one he was wee, sure the other was small. There were two other devils there tied up in chains, and she lifted her stick and she scattered their brains. So the devil he hoisted her up on his back, they were 7 years going, 9 days coming back. Says he, "Me old man, here's your wife safe and well, for the likes of herself we would not have in hell. Now I've been a devil for most of me life, but I ne'er was in hell till I met with your wife." So it's true that the women is worse than the men. When they go down to hell, they are thrown out again.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.